Mike Brennan is joining us this morning here on Proactive London from Norman Broadbent, of course. Plenty to discuss, including a note from WH Ireland recently outlining the investment case for your recruitment and business group, of course, highlighting that you're a leading specialist in the field of human capital solutions. So we'll go through some of the details of what they've picked up on, your portfolio mix as well as innovative, effective, and perhaps unique as well, just some of the quotes coming from there. We just want to get an idea as to how life is treating you there. So a very good morning to you, Mike. How are you?
Yeah, I'm good. Thank you very much, Kate. It's good to see you again. Where I'm in my office in London. We're getting ready for the big unlock. I think we'll have a kind of a balanced reapproach back into the office, which I'm fine with, just as long as everybody feels safe. But we're very, very bullish about this year. Clearly, we finished last year in a good place, despite the pandemic, and we've come into a good Q1 as well. I think the note you referred to is important. This is the first substantial research note that's been done on Norman Broadbent by an independent analyst, by one of the city brokers, since I came in as chief exec. And you're right, it highlights lots of different things about who we are now, how we've changed. I think it will help reset some investor perceptions. There may be perceptions of what we were once. Well, all of that's been swept aside now because clearly we've hung on to the really good, strong bits, and then we've rebuilt on those foundations to create new and interesting service lines. Mm-hmm. I think the big theme that came out from WH Ireland, and this has just come out, so it's kind of fresh with investors, but the big thing that's come out is that if investors want exposure to the economic uptick, which everybody's talking about now and we're seeing, then it's with a company like ours, perhaps, that they could gain that kind of positive exposure to that economic uplift that we're all expecting to see. Mm-hmm. Obviously, it's dug deep into other things as well. So it talks about the annuity income streams that we've got. It talks about quality of revenue. Clearly, we posted a profit at EBITDA level last year. We've made that clear in our trading statement. Our net fee income was slightly down last year, but actually we were better than the market. So again, you know, that's a very positive thing. I think probably what WH Ireland are also saying, if you read between the lines, is that this company needs re-rating. People need to look at it in a different way. And that's why we feel quite positive about the note. And we very much hope that we're going to start to see some positive traction in terms of trading.
Excellent. I love this positivity as well, talking about the uptick coming with the UK economy in general. And they said one of the best recognised names as well among senior level decision makers too.
Yeah. So we've got a great brand. Our brand we've touched so many senior decision makers in the UK corporate marketplace. So within a certain demographic, and they tend to be sat on main boards now or just below main board, they tend to be very senior executives, chairs of businesses, senior non-execs. They will know us. And they know us because either we've moved them, we've tapped them on the shoulder, or we've worked for them when they've been running companies. And what that creates is this fabulous halo effect, which means that we get entry at very, very senior level in companies now, which means that we can get to have the conversations with a lot of other companies can't have. And what it also means is that as we're re-educating the market about what we're doing now, about the six different service lines that we've got, it means that they can start to refer us across their businesses. So basically they refer us down to their senior leadership teams or management teams. And about a quarter of our business now is a direct result of an internal referral from a client or a colleague. And when I came into the business, we had none, virtually none. So that shows a big shift in how we've positioned ourselves with clients, how we've brought ourselves to their attention, and how we've created this much more collegiate business and team that's obviously benefiting clients, it's benefiting colleagues, and ultimately it will benefit the owners of the company, which are our shareholders.
Mm-hmm. And Mike, you're referring there to the brand itself facilitating the growth of complementary activities, as you call it, this halo effect, and really helping to drive the high levels of this cross-selling, which is crucial to your success.
Yeah, you're right. One of the things that we had to do is we had to let clients know that we were still here and what we were doing. And we invested very heavily in digital marketing a few years ago. And we were one of the few companies in our space that started to digitally engage with the most senior business leaders in the market, but do it on a regular basis. And what we found is when we went into the pandemic, the uptake on people wanting to meet us, driven by that digital engagement, absolutely rocketed. We don't outsource any of our digital marketing. We do it all in-house. They're all about stories, about case studies. And where clients have been in a difficult position, which many of them have been challenged last year, they've referenced their difficulties with some of the case studies that we've got. And that's driven a huge amount of business our way. So, I'm very proud of what we've done from that perspective. It's been remarkably positive. And you're right, that whole halo effect, again, has opened doors for us that that won't get open for a lot of other companies.
Mm-hmm. Let's maybe finish as well, because you've alluded to this a bit earlier on about your exposure to the UK's uptick that we're all hoping for towards the end of this year. Maybe just talk to us about how you're positioned for that, to be able to seize upon it.
Okay. That's a really, really interesting question, okay? And it ties into our growth strategy. So clearly we've got these six different service lines now, which I've talked about in the past. We used to have one, now we've got six. That means that we can have more relevant, more interesting conversations with our clients. So we're now more like a problem solver or a solution provider, as opposed to a transactional recruitment business, which we were a few years ago. What that means is that clients can talk to us. They can talk to us about not just how can I find somebody, but what does my market look like? So we use research. Where can I find the best talent? We use research. I need specialist expertise for 6 months. I don't want to commit to a full-time employee. So therefore we use our interim management consultants on that. My people, I think they're not great. Can I develop them? So we use assessment and development tools for that as well. So there are lots of different ways that we can come at a client and help them go through some of these problems. But that made me think long and hard about the strategy for how we grow. So we can grow our business organically, and we've got a very clear plan around that. And we're adding people in the business in different ways now. And we're about to expand in the north of England as well further. But we're also now in conversations with potential partners. And those people might be owners of smaller recruitment businesses where, like we once were, we just did one thing. And what we can say to them is if they're the right business and they're in the right space, they've got the right brand, what we can say to them is partner with us and you can start to pull our service lines through your company. And suddenly overnight, that company, instead of doing one thing, they can do six. And there's no lag time, there's no investment required. And we will basically help them build out their capability using our capability. So we'll be able to evidence it with clients, we'll be able to market it with them, and we'll be able to execute it for them. And that then creates a pool of partnerships. It then creates, I think, an interesting funnel of potential M&A activity later on as well. So we're having a selected number of conversations like that at the moment in terms of how we can grow our business. And obviously that feeds into that economic uptick that I'm talking about, because there's a lot of activity out there. It's definitely picked up in the last few weeks. And as a business, we're exactly where we thought we should be right now.
Excellent. Well, not many businesses can say that. So that's an achievement in itself. Mike, thank you very much indeed. All ready for the big unlock there at Broadbent. Thank you for your time.
Great to see you again. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.